Fallacies of relevance are attempts to convince through non-logical means. They encompass a wide variety of tactics, appeals to feelings, direct attacks towards the opponent in the argument that divert the attention from the argument at hand. If the fallacy is used intentionally, then it is called a red herring. It is a reference to the fishes that were used when training dogs to test whether they could be distracted by a strong smell. The underlying idea is that you are intentionally throwing your opponent off path. It's like creating false clues to distract the investigator, if you want another metaphor. They are absolutely everywhere. In advertisement, look, it's new, so it must be good. Appeal to novelty. Talking about alternative medicine, it's natural, so it must be good for you. Oh, that's an appeal to nature, by the way. Let's dwell a bit on one of the most famous examples, the ad hominem. If you have siblings, you must have been confronted to this fallacy since your youngest age. You know, you start accusing someone of something, and his or her way of fighting back consists in doing the same thing. Oh, I did something wrong, but do you remember when you did blah, 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 blah. You get the idea. You try to discredit the person by highlighting contradictions in his or her discourses. However, it has to be related to the topic at hand. You are going to oppose to the people with his own words or own actions. It is slightly different from the ad personam type of argument, where you try to discredit your adversary without referring to the situation at hand. In the ad personam situation, you completely forget about the object of the argument to focus on the opponent and most likely his or her flaws. While in the ad hominem, you are still talking about the arguments, even if you point out contradictions in the discourse of the other person. There are a few typologies of ad hominem on the internet, and the subcategory tu quoque, or you too in English, is probably the most famous one. It is the case of the example of the siblings. I let you with this illustration, commonly found on the web, of a Highlander mocking the headgear of a woman who was asking about it. Another typology is presented by scholars from Duke universities with three types of arguments: silences, dismisses, and deniers. But here is not the place to dwell on the topic, and I'll let you go see the pedagogical content if you want to delve into it.